Thank you very much. Had I not known that Himanshu Thakkar and Rohit are the co and chair and co-chair, I would have considered KJ Joy to be the chair because he is sitting on a very different chair. Okay. Yours is red chair. All other are black chairs. Come on. It's a different chair. So, but he, nevertheless, okay, that's fine. That's just beside the point. Okay, our group had about 18 participants and the age group was 18 months to 65 plus. The 18 months candidate could not contribute much because she was busy in other affairs, but the others all contributed. And the wishful topic that was given to us, as Himanshu has rightly mentioned, was dam decommissioning and restored rivers. And as I mentioned, we were only about 18 people, so I'm sorry to report, it's a breaking news, that we could not decommission any dam because of very few people. Okay. Now, the discussions that we had, I would say it's a work yet to begin, because decommissioning in India is not yet known, literally. We always give example of other countries, including US, where 11,000 plus dams and weirs have been decommissioned, plus some in other countries, including in Southeast Asia, like Thailand, etc. So the decommissioning is a fairly new concept here. So we spent quite a lot of time discussing what decommissioning is and what decommissioning actually means in the real context. So this time, this took us a lot of time. So, and also we kept in mind the fact that Mulla Periyar Dam, which in all fairness should be ready for decommissioning because it is 125-year-old dam. And we also know the legal and political tangle in which it is trapped currently. So the whole idea of decommissioning has to be in the framework of the Mulla Periyar controversy, which is currently there. So we kept that in mind all the time. So in the Indian context, as I mentioned earlier, the whole idea is fairly new. And so our discussions were like, you know, exploring the possibilities and potentials of putting the arguments in favor of decommissioning in the environment which is totally pro-dam building. That's one. Also, we felt that the arguments favoring decommissioning, if there are any, are in a very nascent stage, both in terms of arguments, language, and its presentation. Language we discussed at a great length. Whether we speak the language of the dam proponents using the same parameters that you use, or we have our own phrases and idioms to do that. Now, I think this issue is still a work in progress. We haven't been able to arrive at any consensus, although there were very potential arguments put forth, like, for example, the Kosi Basin, the arguments were there in terms of decommissioning of the embankments, and they have the data and the information, all possible data and information in favor of decommissioning, and yet it is not happening anytime soon. So we have to locate what is the idiom, what is the language, what is the phrase that we are going to use to be able to sell the idea of decommissioning, or at least push that idea as a new idea into the minds of those who are in favor of dams. The third important point that we talked about is the fact that there is a politics which I call potential politics of dam building versus the kinetic politics of decommissioning. So there are two contrasting positions here, and we get to see that the potential politics of dam building is at an advantageous situation currently, and the kinetic potential of decommissioning, which most of us represent here, is still at a very weak ground. Now, having said that, we thought that this idea is fairly new, as Himanshu has already mentioned, wishful thinking, but we nevertheless felt that at the time, we have to start building up that kind of momentum, that kind of, you know, detailed studies and analysis to be done, at least picking up a couple of dams, if not more, and to present it, argue it, using a language which is both comfortable and which is fairly new in favor of decommissioning. So this was in all that we could discuss. But in discussing this, since the work on decommissioning has yet to begin, I must also say that our group discussed a lot about various other associated interesting subjects like Heer Ranja and Sohni Mahiwal, because they're all love stories of the past which are linked to rivers anyway in Multan region. So we all talked about all those possibilities. So love, devotion, and junoon, ishq, mohabbat, ibadat, all those things figured into it. We thought, can we use these folklore to push the idea of possibly decommissioning. I'm not saying it's going to happen anytime soon, but those were the ideas discussed. And as I mentioned again, it's work which is yet to begin. Thank you very much. Oh, yes, sir.
Just
1 minute. Abhini?
First one, anybody from their group wants to add anything? Anything missing?
No.
Okay. Any questions? Yeah. Okay. Briefly. You see, 1 minute. She's from the same group, yeah.
Very important was that it was important to mention that the current politics where smart city and more smart cities and urbanization is the larger context that we are living in today. How will any talk of decommissioning of dams be successful in this kind of an environment with a blueprint that is going in for large-scale urbanization, large-scale industrialization? So that was one point that we needed to keep in mind when we talk of decommissioning.
Thank you. Thank you. You're in the same group?
Yes.
Okay. Briefly, please.
सर जैसे मैंने ग्रुप में भी निवेदन करा था कि डीकमिशनिंग हम कर सकते हैं करना भी चाहिए लेकिन उसका सब्स्टिट्यूट क्या होगा जैसे कि ये लाइट जल रही है बाइक चल रहा है तो सब्स्टिट्यूट कैसे चाहिए तो सुझाव ये आया था कि हम तालाबों के ऊपर काम कर सकते हैं और सोलर एनर्जी सिंचाई के लिए तालाबों के लिए पे काम कर सकते हैं और अल्टरनेटिव एनर्जी के लिए सोलर और विंड एनर्जी पे काम कर सकते हैं तो सर ये भी प्लीज़ इसको भी पॉइंट करिए क्योंकि अगर हम इन चीज़ों को विषय को बिना छेड़ते हुए भी डीकमिशनिंग पे बात करेंगे तो शायद हमें भी नक्सलाइट या उग्रवादी या कुछ इस तरह की बात बोल दी जाएगी धन्यवाद
थैंक यू ओके बिफोर वी गो इन टू इंटरेक्शंस आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू पॉइंट आउट दैट In addition to Mulla Periyar, another dam which has been very actively discussed for decommissioning is the Dumbur Dam in Tripura. In fact, it was an election issue in the last assembly elections in Tripura, and there was a political consensus across board that this dam needs to be decommissioned. And its installed capacity was 22 megawatts, but it has never generated more than 7 megawatts, and it is submerged some 20,000 hectares of land for 7 megawatt of electricity. Yeah, now it's even less. So, but the only party which was not part of this political consensus was the left party, CPM, which is the ruling party in Tripura, and which won the election. So that was unfortunate part. Otherwise, there was much farther progressed on that.
Okay.
And Subir Bhomik from BBC has written extensively on this issue. So that's another issue. There are a couple of barrages which has been decommissioned for replacement. For example, Hathni Kund. When Hathni Kund was constructed, Tajiwala was earlier. So there was a decommissioning. Narora barrage, similarly, the older barrage. So there is some such these things. Anyway, now, any questions? We can, yeah. You're part of the group? Okay.
One thing that people who restore rivers complain about is that there are not even photography or plans of the dam that is available to them year after. So these are kind of things which I think are... But the other thing is also let's not, live in the hype of other countries and what they do, and particularly the fact that as if decommissioning is the solution. Decommissioning itself is a huge task and brings in a lot of problems, and it requires not only technological, but also it requires an ability to rebuild, to restore the ecosystem of the river and the people living around it. It's not just an easy solution as if, we get rid of a dam and everything comes as it was.
That's true. Yeah, very good points. Yeah.
points that we also discussed were, initially when you said that the cost of the decommissioning should be included, then it was clarified later in the group by Parinita, I think, that it is already there in the EIA report, they have to say it, but they don't, they just write none against it. So nobody is held accountable or responsible for the decommissioning. And then there was this, in the yesterday's session, we had this important recommendation that there should be a post facto EIA assessment. And there should be some kind of a license or some kind of a renewal after maybe 5 years or so. And if that is the conditions are not complied with, then there should be some kind of punishment. That was there. And then there was this discussion about what is the mindset that even stops us from considering this possibility of decommissioning. Once the dams are there, they are considered to be a holy cow. So much money has already gone into it. So, and it is also considered as a fail. I mean, it's difficult to accept your failure then by the government that something is not working. And so these things were also discussed.
Thank you. Yes?
Sorry, another more point. So countries which actually decommission dams, imagine they even decommission them just because they, that's fortunate actually, there are not sufficient passages or the granite in such for which salmons are not able to go back to the reservoir or to come up from the river. But what, just to add to your point, is the holy cow of the dam is seen also in the fact that decommissioning, what is the process in India for decommissioning a dam, but in other countries is actually, many authorities can decommission a dam, even if other authorities are, it's not so difficult to do so. There are not many, much more permissions are required to build a dam than to decommission a dam. So probably looking into who is the authority for decommission dam would be something even interesting. And often decommissioning a dam does not even require the permission of the owner or of the manager. So, which I think it's a... there is a national interest.
We don't need to go into those details actually now at this stage.
Well, I thought that those are recommendations that we can bring in.
Thank
so
you.
You know.
Thank you. Yeah, please be brief. Yeah.
He's not group now. He's not member.
Very brief. तो एक तो ये है कि जब कुसा बांध टूट गया उस समय पर बिहार के कुछ साथियों की डिमांड थी कि अब इसको ना जोड़ा जाए और इसके अब इसके हिसाब से ही आगे काम चले और जो अदर दैन द अमेंडमेंट जो कुसा जो बैरेज जो बना हुआ है कुसी बैरेज जो बना हुआ है उसके डिज़ाइन के ऊपर जो है पूरे बहुत सारे सवाल रहे हैं और ये रहा है कि इसको तोड़ के एक नया डिज़ाइन इसका जो पहले कंसीव किया गया था वो बनना चाहिए तो ये बिल्कुल अलग कॉन्टेक्स्ट है डिकमिशनिंग का. दूसरा ये है कि आई वंडर कि जो हमारे यहाँ पे डैम एक्सपर्ट्स बैठे हुए हैं, एक वर्ल्ड बैंक का पूरा बहुत बड़ा प्रोजेक्ट है करीब 2000 करोड़ रुपये का हिंदुस्तान में जो रिजर्वायर्स एंडेंजर्ड हैं उनको रिहेबिलिटेट करने का. जी 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 बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. तो उसमें हाउ मच इज द डेंजर ऑफ यू नो डैम्स बस्टिंग ऑन देयर ओन लाइक कुसा ब्रोक सो दैट गेट्स लिंक्ड टू द होल डीकमिशनिंग. थैंक यू.
वेरी ब्रीफली द लास्ट इंटरवेंशन
एंड द लास्ट
या बिकॉज़ वी हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सपोज्ड ऑन द टाइम ऑफ
दिस यू हैड ब्रॉट इन सोनी महवाल एंड अदर्स तो उनका कोई गाना भी आपने गाया कि नहीं?
Let's skip that. Thank you.
No, there is one other question.
बोले बोले क्या उसमें खासियत है कुछ?
आप गाना गा के बता सुना सकेंगे?
मैं नहीं सुना था. आप सुनाए. आप सुनाइए.
Okay. What I want to ask was that the hot dam, which has completely failed, and which has caused a huge adverse effect for the nation, has there been any proposal? Or are we proposing to not only decommission but remove that dam? The river is Bhagirathi. It has been lost to the nation. So, did we discuss whether that?
Oh yes, we did. We did it. You know, if you see the interventions by the group members, we had a very long discussion on various reasons for decommissioning. So, we were arguing on the decommissioning. Energy was one. Irrigation was another. Power was another. you know, fisheries was another issue, Schedule 1 species was another issue. We discussed all that. And what we were trying to say is, are these arguments sufficient enough to put forth an argument against dam, both in terms of decommissioning as well as the new dams which are currently being thought of being built. So this was discussed and debated at length. The only problem that we face is that we do not have enough data and information to be able to argue our case better. That's one. And secondly, in the economic terms, how do we then prove that decommissioning is more useful than commissioning a dam? So these were the issues that were currently being debated. And we were drawing upon experiences, as she mentions, from the US or from other places. Those things were constantly being debated, including the embankment of Kosi. The issues were discussed threadbare.
No, but as far as Terry is concerned, there is plenty of evidence as to why it should be this.
I think let us leave it. Mm-hmm. That's a different issue.
No, but you did not discuss that.
We did mention, Terry was talked about. But you know, as Himanshu mentioned, we if you ask me, the entire group was in favor of decommissioning all the dams. But then that was the wishful thinking. So not to mention Terry, we talked about all possible dams, including Bhakhara and others. We talked about them, and I think everyone agreed for decommissioning. But that was our wish list, and that's what we have presented here.
Gautam, in Chhattisgarh, one of the dams was handed over to the private company,
dam?
Irrigation dam, and then it was decommissioned. You remember that? Through assembly. Anyway, I don't remember the details. We'll get that anyway. Thank you very much.